Hey guys, Welsknight here, bringing you another brand new episode of ARK Survival Evolved, and... oh, I'm gonna die. I'm dead. Oh. That is the second time that Sabretooth has killed me. And, I don't really have much I can do about it. That's kind of the problem that I'm running into. He's got all my stuff. I did some work between episodes, gathering, you know, some rocks and some wood and some stuff and some things. And, well, I keep losing it. I keep dying and I keep dying and I keep dying. And the reason for that is because I chose to spawn on the northern side of the island, and there are not all that many stones around here. Which means that every time that I respawn, it takes me quite a while to get... tell me that's... oh, okay. Oh, nope, nope, nope. Those things are bad. Those things are bad. Run away, run away, run away. They will kill you. I got killed by one of those at the end of last episode. So far, we've encountered... and there's a Dilo. Great. Just what we need. Another thing that can kill me. There are too many things in this game that are very good at killing me. And I don't like it. Can we just, like, chill up here for a minute? I'm gonna try and level up. That bird is still coming my way. I think we need to increase our movement speed. And also, I would really like to learn how to make... what's a simple bed do? Acts as a respawn point. Requires that I know how to make the hide sleeping bag, though. Oh no. Get away. Run. And the thing can fly, so I don't think I'm going to be able to outrun it. Oh, man. We're going to try to outrun. Escape and evade. Okay. We found dodos. I think I'm safe here for a minute. Whew. Okay, so, let's try this again. So, in order to make the bed, I need to know how to make the hide sleeping bag. Alright, well, I'm pretty sure that I'm reasonably certain that having a respawn point would be amazingly useful. Let's also do the door frame, maybe? And the wall. This way we're kind of building up our ability to kind of get a base going. We'll have to see. We'll have to see if this works. I still have not really found anything for stone, though. That's... note to self, don't spawn on the north side of the island next time. Oh, there we go. Got a little stone. Okay. So now that we have some stone, now we can get some thatch, we can get some wood, we can get some of that kind of stuff that we need to make the basic pick. Why did my sound just die? Oh, never mind. I think I accidentally turned down the volume on my headphones a little bit too far. That's okay. Alright, let's get a little bit more of this stuff. Do we have enough? Yeah, that should be enough. So let's craft the stone pick. And we can make the shirt as well right away. So I suppose we should probably do that. And let's put that on. That'll at least... give us a little bit of protection. Not as much as we're gonna need, but it'll give us a little bit. And now we can finally work on getting some stone by actually mining it. I wish that they would increase the generation of just stone on all of the beaches. Cause it's frustratingly difficult sometimes to actually find the stone you need just to make your first tool, and I don't think that's a good way to do things, but that's just me. Maybe you're supposed to spawn on one side of the island when you're first kind of starting out, And then, you know, I'm dehydrated. Okay, well, let's go into the water. Let's rehydrate. Okay, we can consider ourselves now rehydrated. Yay! Okay, so up onto the beach we go. Apparently you can also find fish in the water, which you can actually kill. So that might come in handy. I should now be able to make a hatchet and a torch. I'm sure I'll need those sooner or later. There we go. And the next thing that I need to work towards is definitely a spear. So I think we're going to get some more wood. There we go. What do we actually need for this spear that we don't have? Fiber. Okay. Well, fiber is not super difficult to find. You basically just run through all the plant life and just keep hitting E to gather berries and fiber and berries and fiber. And berries. And fiber. But anyway, so hopefully we'll find some stuff. We're also getting some stone as we're going through here as well. So maybe this is an area where you can actually find some stone. Just kind of lying around in the ground. I feel like I probably shouldn't be going this far inland, but then again, we've had amazing luck on the beaches, so who knows? Maybe we'll be alright either way. Or maybe we'll die either way. I guess only ta! What is attacking? Oh, one of those bird things! Ah, grr! Well, stupid bird. I see it over there, and I see Dilos. So that means that my stuff is over there. I suppose that's a good thing. We should also see if we can find our base, because I think our base is somewhere along this beach as well. Maybe. Maybe not. We'll just kind of take a peek over here real quick. No, it doesn't seem to be, because I think it was like right in one of these areas, so I'm not seeing our old base that we made. That's unfortunate. All right, let's head off this way. We'll see if we can maybe get our stuff back. I'm not extremely optimistic, but I guess we'll find out. We'll see what we can do. The dinosaurs here, they are just mean. They're just mean. Let me know what you guys think. Maybe I'll start over. Maybe I'll start a new character. And I'll start on the southern side of the island, the default. Maybe that'll make a difference. And that way we can actually progress in the game a little bit instead of just dying constantly. Because dying constantly really isn't all that fun. I guess we'll see. In the meantime, I'm going to work on gathering fibers, gathering berries, and hopefully getting back to my stuff here pretty soon. Which should be, like, right over... That wasn't... Okay. I thought that was a dinosaur chasing me for a minute. Oh, it's coming for me! It's coming for me! Run! Run like the wind! Run away, run away, run away, run away! Yeah, eat this dinosaur. Eat this thing. Eat that. Please, just eat him. Don't eat me. I don't taste good. I'm not properly seasoned. Dodo birds. Okay. What? Oh, the bird. Grr, those birds. They're just infuriating. Okay. I wonder if I can respawn me. See, the thing is, it says it respawns you in a random location, but it, really? I spawn into the game and I'm instantly getting attacked. This is unbelievable. unbelievable. Okay, let's see if we can download my old character? No. I guess we will respawn yet again because dying is fun. Grr. Okay. Let's try heading off this way. Maybe we can make it back to some of our stuff. We've had plenty of deaths, so maybe we'll actually be able to find one of our old backpacks and that has tools and stuff like that in it. Because when you die, your stuff stays behind, although it does despawn after a while. I don't know how long it takes, what the actual despawn time is. I think it's... That looks like my base. That's my base from before. Oh! Happy day, we are saved. Okay. In that case, I should have a stone in there. I should have wood in here. And I should have plenty of thatch in here as well, which means... where's my stone? There we go. Let's just take all that, and let's take all the flint too. And the fiber. And the hide will wait on. And then we should be able to craft all sorts of goodies. So let's do the pick. Let's do the torch. Let's do the spear. And let's do the hatchet. So we're doing basically all of our basic tools in one go. Oh, I'm so glad that we found our base. I am so glad. That's a lucky break, without a doubt. So now that that's done, now we can take a lot of this stuff, put it back, and that will definitely help us out. This thing is pretty much full. Let's take the berries out and put those in there instead. Yeah, that'll do. Ooh, and actually, we should look and see. What do walls cost? 7 fiber, 10 thatch, and 2 wood. Okay, well, I've got everything except for the fiber. So, let's go ahead and see if we can get ourselves some more fiber then. That would be a great start. If we can get some walls on our little house, that would be a huge, huge benefit. That'll help keep us safe at night, and it'll also help us find our base a little bit easier, because it'll stick out a little bit more. It'll be a little easier to find, shall we say. I should double check. I don't suppose it shows me coordinates, does it? Kind of. No, it just says the northern shore. Doesn't give me exact locations or anything along those lines. Alright guys, I'm gonna grab some fiber, and I'll be back in a moment. Alright guys, I am back, and I do have a pretty solid amount of fiber. I've got a little over 100 right now. So we're gonna head over here, and we're gonna make some walls for our house. I don't know, I should have enough to make it all. We'll find out. Let's see. Oh, jumping. There we go. So let's see. In order to make walls, I need thatch and wood. Well, I got plenty of thatch. Come on, thatch. There we go. And I also have plenty of wood. So that shouldn't be a big deal. So let's see here. We're going to need 1, 2. That was scary. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there's 6 walls. So basically we're gonna need like 5 walls. Cause one of them's gonna have to be the door frame. So let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have to make them all at one time. And then we'll make a door frame. And then it looks like we still have enough fiber left over to make ourselves some pants and a shirt. So let's do that while we're at it. And I think we'll have to wait for the next level up to make the roof and the actual door. But this will be a very good start. So we'll take our wall, put that in our hotbar, take the door, take the pants and put them on. take the door frame, put it on our hotbar, and take the shirt and put it on. There we go. So, let's see. Where do we want our walls? I think we want one wall right there. We want a wall right there. I think we're going to put our door kind of right here near the campfire, is what I'm thinking. And this will be maybe like our little bedroom area type thing. And let's see, door frame goes there. So this is kind of our little thatch hut. It's not much to look at, but it will do the job, at least for the time being. I should also see how much does another storage box cost. Okay, that's actually pretty affordable. So maybe I'll make another one of those too. We don't need a whole lot of fiber. We just need like 4 more fiber to make that. So why don't we work on making one more storage box too, just because I'm kind of a hoarder. It's true. I like to collect things and gather things and then never get rid of them. So let's see here. We'll go into here. We got the wood, we got the fiber, and we have the thatch. So let's make one more storage box as well. There we go. And then, why don't we put this one? I don't suppose I can put it right next to this one, can I? Oh, it was green for a sec. It could go right here. I don't think I want to put it right in the door, though. I think I'm actually going to put this one outside. Like, maybe right... Maybe we'll put it on the side, like right over here. Or... We'll put it right there. That seems like a good location for it. And then in this one, we can put a lot of our other extra stuff as well. Stone, berries, you know, things like that. So there we go. And I think that is pretty much all that we have time for in this episode, guys. So if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave me a comment. I do appreciate it, and it really helps out my channel. You can also find me on Facebook, Twitter, and Twitch. There are links in the video description below, so check that out as well. Otherwise, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll definitely see you next time. Oh, there's a hole in the floor. Excellent. Can I get in over here, maybe? Is there something worthwhile and worth my time over here? Oh, no.